Hi, I'm Alan Muldoon. I'm the bike test editor at MBR, and I rode all 24 bikes in this year's Hardtail of the Year test. So even though I oversaw the whole test, my focus was the 500-pound category. I had six bikes, and the winning bike was the Vitus Nucleus 27.5VR. Now I'm gonna quickly run through the other five bikes in the test, but I'm not gonna focus on them because there's only one bike to buy if you've got 500 pounds to spend, and that's this one. So in sixth position with the five rating, we had the KTM Chicago. In fifth position was the Specialized Pitch Sport. Next up was the Trek Marlin 6 29-inch wheels. In fourth spot was the Caliber Rake, and we rated that bike an 8. Next up, and the only bike to come close to the Vitus, was the Pinnacle Kapoor 2, and that bike got rated a 9. So you're probably wondering what made the Vitus so good. Everything, really. It had the best fork, it had the best frame and geometry, it had the best tires, it had the best wheels, it had the best drivetrain. There's not a single thing on this bike that wasn't better than all of its rivals. So let's start with the fork, because that's actually what makes the biggest difference to the quality of the ride. This Suntour fork, it's got chunky 32 mil stanchions, so these upper tubes here, so it makes the fork nice and stiff, but really what makes it better than any other fork is that it's air sprung. So all you've got to do is take a shock pump, add or subtract air from the air spring, and you can adjust the ride height of the fork for like different rider weights, which is great, because it means that someone who's small and maybe riding the size small and weighs like 65 kilos, they can get the fork set up exactly how they want it. Or someone who's like riding the large or the XL and they're weighing like 100 kilos, they can still get this fork to work for them. And a key part of that is that it has rebound damping adjustment, and that's the only fork in the 500 pound class to have that. Now last year, Vitus made a host of revisions to the frame. They made it longer, they made it slacker, they introduced butted tubing. So this year, it's kind of like it's not messed with its winning formula. It's made a subtle change to the specification, however. The bike now comes with slightly wider profile WTB rims. And these are great because they give the tires like that little bit more stability when you're running lower pressures. You've got a 2.25 trail boss in the rear, which is fast rolling. So it makes it efficient when you're climbing because you've got more weight on the rear of the bike. And then you've got the high grip compound Vigilante on the front. So it's a bigger volume, but it's also softer rubber. And so basically that means when you're loading the front end in corners, you've got way more grip and it just gives you tons of confidence. So the other thing that I really like about the Vitus is that it has a 2x drivetrain. So rather than having three chain rings on the front, it only has two. And this means that like your chains kind of, you've got better chain management. It's easier to shift gears between the smaller and the bigger ring than when you have a triple setup. It's actually now got a shadow style rear mech. So the rear mech's really low profile. So it means like when you're nipping between some rocks or around tight corners where there's stumps and things sticking out, it's less likely to hit. But there's still no clutch mech on the Vitus. So it means the chain does rattle and it does come off because you can ride this bike so hard. I mean, that's the biggest issue. You get to the bottom of a run, you've gone absolutely flat out, and you look down, you go, oh my God, the chain's come off again. I mean, it's happened a number of times when we were shooting the video, and it's just gonna happen. And until you fit a clutch rear mech, there's no way around it. On the plus side, there is a neoprene chainstay protector on there, so that cancels a lot of the noise from the chain slap. And maybe if you're riding smoother terrain and not trying to push the bike so hard, you won't have the same issues with the chain coming off all the time. Maybe next year, if that technology trickles down to the 500 pound price point, we'll see it on this bike, but it's not there yet. So you said it's got the best fork and test, but it's also got a really good cockpit. It has a nice wide bar, has a good profile. It's got a short stem. It's got lock on grips. So first ride out on this in the rain, your grips aren't gonna be spinning. They're not gonna come off. And again, that's all about inspiring confidence. The Tektor brakes are hydraulic, so they're basically super low maintenance. They did take quite a bit of time to scrub in, however, and Vitus has gone for 160mm rotors front and rear. And while I don't really think you need a bigger rotor on the rear of a hardtail because the back wheel's off the ground half the time, it would be nice to maybe have a 180 on the front just so you've got a little bit more confidence when you're going down steep chutes or when you just really want to like stop in a straight line, you can hit the front brake real hard because you've got the Vigilante tire with the soft compound, so you've got the grip with the tires on the trail. You just need the braking power to really maximize that. So like out of the box, this bike is simply amazing. I mean, and if there's one upgrade you'd probably wanna make to it, is you'd probably wanna spend 100 pound on a dropper post. And the frame comes with internal cable routing for a dropper. It goes in here, it comes out the back of the seat tube, it goes up inside, so there's no like unruly cables outside, and that would really transform the ride. So this bike, in various forms, like this is the latest version, it's won the 500 pound category 4 years in a row. I mean, no other bike comes close to it, and every year, when they do get closer, Vitus seems to like inch ahead again. So I've really talked about the individual component parts of this bike, what makes it so good, but that kind of like, it's the bigger picture of like how it rides is what makes this bike stand out. I can do whatever I want on this bike. I don't feel inhibited by it in any way. Whereas some of the hardtails, when I'm testing them, I'm like, oh, the brakes aren't very good. I'm not very confident. Oh, the geometry is a bit squirrely, or oh, the fork tops out. There's always something that kind of inhibits your ability to ride exactly how you want to. But on like the Vitus, you just feel like you've been set free. You can just do whatever you want. So whether that's getting air, smashing turns, or just basically like grinding up climbs, the Vitus was just head and shoulders above every other bike in that category. I mean, it's a bit of a cliche, but Warren Buffett says to be successful in business, you have to have one of three qualities. You gotta be the cheapest, you gotta be the most convenient, or you gotta be the best. Well, the Vitus, they've nailed it. This bike comes in a box, so it's super convenient. It's got the best parts for your money, so it's definitely cheap. And it's also got the best ride quality, so it ticks all three boxes.